It's good to be with you on this Thursday edition of the Word of Encouragement. These are interesting days. Things have opened up more and you've got all of the of life going back to semi-normal. And yet at the same time, Christians are seeing very concerning signs of a darkness prevailing across our country. The moral revolution is in full force, especially in this month. And we have the political swirling of different objectives that go contrary to biblical values. And it could be very easy for us to be overwhelmed. And whenever I'm tempted to do so, I cannot help but think of Daniel, who was put right in the middle of a heathen kingdom and was, as a younger man, was given about every temptation there possibly could be, and yet he did not fall for that, he nor his friends. He worshiped his God, and God blessed him over and over. In fact, he had a part in turning the whole direction of the kingdom. And then, when the Medo-Persian kingdom took over, he again had a place of great power because he was willing to trust his God, and he had a holy optimism that even in the darkest day, God was working. And I love the story in Daniel chapter 6, where you have the leadership under Darius wanting to get rid of Daniel. He was a real affront to their leadership. And we read in verse 3, "Then this Daniel was preferred above the presidents and princes because an excellent spirit was in him, and the king thought to set him over the whole realm." Now, it did make a lot of sense for him to do that. You would have thought out of the Medo-Persian counselors, he would have had his top man. And yet, he knew the hand of God was upon Daniel. There was an excellent spirit. We find that several times throughout the book of Daniel. God glorified, magnified Daniel because the spirit of God's presence was upon him. And God was able to accomplish great things. You know, it's so easy for us to find ourselves either overwhelmed by what's happening in our culture, or feeling like we have to capitulate to the culture to get along and to advance ourselves. But we find in this wonderful example of Daniel that neither of those things happened. Daniel was burdened for the Jewish people, but he had absolute confidence in the greatness and power of his God, that God would answer prayer and that God would navigate through all that was going on, and God would accomplish his purposes and he would fulfill his word. And then certainly compromise was not in Daniel's thought process. That wonderful verse 8 of chapter 1, where Daniel purposed in his heart not to defile himself, even when it came just to the issues of food. He was going to obey God. And because of his uncompromising spirit, God gave him an excellent spirit, wisdom, just tremendous ability that was beyond even his natural abilities, so that he was able to encourage the Jewish people by having an enormous role in both the Babylonian Empire and the Medo-Persian Empire. My friends, today, we need to realize that the thing that we need is an excellent spirit, not a down spirit, and certainly not a compromising spirit. We need to be men and women of God who believe that God is on the throne and he will honor our trust in him. And we want to show forth in this dark day that God is alive, God's working, and that God's power is still real, and to see many people reached with the gospel.